Now, you saw that it's pretty complicated to calculate the standard deviation, but what's so great about it? Why don't we just find the average absolute deviation? Why do we have to square each deviation, find the average square, and then take the square root? Doesn't it seem like a lot of extra complicated steps? Well, actually, the standard deviation is really cool, and it helps us a lot when we do statistical analysis. It turns out that with a normal distribution, and if you remember, that's where the mean equals the median equals the mode, right in the center of the distribution, which is symmetrical, the standard deviation has great properties. Approximately 68% of the data falls within one standard deviation of the mean. So here's one standard deviation on each side, and I'm using the lowercase sigma to represent standard deviation. So 68% of the data falls between this value, which is x bar minus one standard deviation, and this value, which is x bar plus one standard deviation. And 95% of the data falls within two standard deviations. So this value here is x bar, the mean, plus two standard deviations, and this value is x bar minus two standard deviations. So 95% of the data will be between this value and this value. In fact, we can approximate how much data will lie in between any number of standard deviations from the mean. We know this because some poor mathematician calculated this for us and put it all into a really nice table. We're going to use this table a lot in the course, but not yet.